Sepp, is this maybe the most important, the most beautiful week in your career? What's coming up?
Yeah, I think for sure it's been definitely the week with, well, the past weeks at least have been the weeks with the most new experiences and also beautiful experiences. And I think this next week is one that, even without being in this position, a week that I would be looking forward to. I love the climbs in Cantabria and Asturias. They're my kind of climbs, the steep climbs that you see in the Vuelta. And yeah, I'm feeling really good and looking forward to this week.
Has it been said out loud by your bosses? Okay, guys, listen, he's our leader until now. He's strong. We are going for Sepp Kuss or not?
I think not directly. We want to keep, obviously, the situation we have now, but you know, there's no, there's no gifts. There's no overcomplicating how we use the three of us. I think, it's nice to have three of us in the position we are now, but we can't overly put overemphasis on that and lose the big picture, which is just winning the race with one of us in the end. So we just have to be honest with ourselves and who's feeling the best, or who has the ability to finish it off in the end.
Backstage, we see you're laughing and giving interviews, but it's quite new for you. Is it something that motivates you also? Because you are on the podium all day, it gives you maybe goosebumps every day. Does it motivate you, or is it a duty?
Yeah, I think for me, this race in the Vuelta is really special because I think it's the race that I identify the most with the people, with the roads. It was my first Grand Tour, and I have more of a special connection with it than a lot of other races. So for me, it's nice to be in this position and feel the affection from the people, and that gives me a lot of motivation. But I can't say if it would be the same in other races where there's even more pressure or scrutiny.
Yeah, I noticed that you used the word confidence a lot since the time trial. Is that a thing that has to grow in your mind, inside your head? Because you're not used to it. You're a super domestique, not a Roglic or a Pogacar or a Vingegaard. Does it have to grow in your mind?
Yeah, for sure. I think this year and especially this race has been a big change for me because I've just had more confidence in myself. I went into the Giro and wasn't sure how I would be because I'd never done the Giro at a high level before, and I wasn't fully prepared to do it. But then when I got there, I thought, oh, I'm in really good shape, and already there mentally, I knew I was going to be good. And then in the Tour, it was a whole nother step up. Then, yeah, in the Tour, I also had just the confidence of myself that I could be with the best guys, and then the same for this race, especially now being in the leader's jersey, I've been able to do more than I would have thought beforehand. And I think that's all just the mental game, more than physical.
Did you already say, joking in the elevator or on the bike, against Jonas or Primoz, hey guys, this year is for me?
Oh, a little bit. I mean, yeah, we all know each other well, and it's nice to see that they also believe in me and are happy for me in the position that I'm in now. But they're also real competitors and they want to win as well, like you see throughout the whole season. And in cycling, there's no gifts or letting off. When you feel good, you can't just hold off. So I think it's fair that way.